Hey, this is Mocha Product Manager Martin Brennand with a quick tip. A Mocha user on the forums recently asked, I've already got my mask drawn in After Effects. How do I apply Mocha tracking data to it without redrawing my shapes? Now, there is a way to make this work, but be pre-warned, it's a little bit ugly. First off, we're going to grab all of our AE masks. Just select all of them and press Ctrl or Command X to cut them out of the layer. Then we create a new solid that's the same size as the comp and paste the masks to that layer. We then use this solid as a track mat by using alpha mat in the original layer. Next, apply Mocha to your original footage layer and launch the Mocha GUI. I'm using Mocha Pro here, but you could also use Mocha AE. Mocha Pro is obviously better though. Now, I'm not going to get into details on tracking here, but in this shot I'm going to draw an X-bind shape on my wall, turn on perspective since there's perspective motion, and I'm going to unlink the shape from the track because I'm lazy and I don't want to keep moving my shape back when it moves off screen. So let's track this and come back when it's done. Okay, we're done now, so here's the important step. We need to go to the frame where our roto shapes have been drawn in After Effects so we can line up our tracking data. Here, it's on frame 41, but yours will obviously vary. Next, we click the Align Surface button to set the reference frame for the tracking data. This is important to make sure that the roto moves as we expect. Now we can close and save the Mocha project and move back to making the tracking data. We'll click the Create Track Data button in the Mocha plugin and choose the track layer. Then, under Export Options, click Corner Pin. Then select the solid we created earlier and click the Apply Export button. Now the tracking data will warp the solid to the correct position and we have our tracked masks ready for use. The downside to this is the mask itself will not follow the cutout because it's stationary, so any modifications you do will have to be offset from the final result. You could get around this by pre-comping your solid with the masks before you apply the tracking data, but that makes it also harder to manipulate the roto later. The best way to avoid this entirely is to always do your masks in Mocha first. As always, if you have any questions, pop over to the forums at borisfx.com. And hey, since you're still here watching the end of the video, why not subscribe for more Mocha tips or comment below to request specific tutorials? We quite enjoy making these things, so if you want to learn something, do let us know.